What a great game. What a way to go out with a bang with Atari's system here. The last game, the fifth game of the series, and it was probably arguably the best one of it because of the steering and how much fun everybody had. Yes, this was the conversion kit. You got the new control panel, new header glass, a new bottom board. You know what, Frank, I meant to put that light in there. Oh, gosh. Please tell me this. Does just one bulb work in this?
Good upkeep on your equipment. Good upkeep.
Frank, can I reach that one?
Nope.
Oh!
Small earthquake in Pennsylvania.
Oh! Ow! Oh, Frank, I can't reach it.
Don't break my chair.
Oh. People will think I'm out of shape.
Nobody would ever think that.
I'm 60 years old. All right, let's look in here. New power supply here. We took both of these boards out. That's the bottom board, the ROM board. All the chips were cleaned. We did the same thing with the top board. All the socketed chips were taken out and cleaned. The board runs on a 68,000. Atari loved that chip. Food Fight was the first game to use it. A very good chip. Then,
it's not a potato. You can't eat it.
So, you got the ROM board,
control panel.
Guess we'll forget header glass. Mentioning servicing the amplifier. That's not important.
Well, we also got the gas pedal. You had to drill holes and mount it in the front. Yes. Did you service the amplifier? Did you take it out and clean it?
I'm just filming it, but give credit where it's due.
Well, we reheated it for sure.
He's huffing and puffing from getting the light.
Mm-hmm.
God, let's need to breathe. You should have more pizza.
And of course, it has two channel ultra stereo. God, I love saying that word. And we can start Bubble City, Forest, and Desert. I'm not very good at this, Frank, so I'm going to start in Bubble City. You can use both triggers to hit. You pick up the green bubbles. I should have slowed down, Frank.
Yeah.
I'm not doing very good, am I, Frank?
Nope.
Well, there's a red bubble. That's a gas bubble, isn't it?
Gas bubble.
Ah. Not bad. Very nice game.
Very, very nice. Great sound.
Back here we got the 7200 monitor. This is a newer monitor. The other one had such heavy burning, we put this beautiful monitor in. Only a few years old. And then we went through and serviced it. Where needed. Looks beautiful. And as an extra treat, we decided to put yellow on one side, red on the other.
That's because you ran out of the yellow.
We have plenty of team molding. Don't we, boys?
Yep.
You know what? I think I hear my beautiful wife up front. And I think we got a package from Mark in Canada. Let's go up. Uh-oh. Another box?
I just came in from Alaska. It's so cold outside.
She couldn't wait to open this up. And it's, once again, it's from Canada.
Oh, it's Fragile.
No, it's Fragile. Don't you watch that
Who's
movie?
She?
Frank, take over here.
Who's she?
She's a very beautiful woman, like you.
What happened to your hair? It's all sticking up.
Is it?
Yeah, now it's better. Oh, my gosh. Look, it's
Wait a minute. I'll use the comb.
Oh, my Lord. What did he get? Is it tickets to Canada? Airplane tickets one way?
One way. One way.
For me, out of the way, come back then. Yay! Oh my gosh! Candy! Oh my gosh. Poor More candy!
Well, these are different. Saltwater taffies.
We had this before.
Oh, we had saltwater?
Yes, we had saltwater. We had, they come in maple and they come in variety pack.
More.
Well, truffles! He got us truffles!
Aren't they tribbles from Star
Ice
Trek?
Ice wine! Uh-oh. Look at that. Oh my God.
Look at this. Canadian True Ice Wine Chocolate.
Oh!
I practice my French. Chocolate Alvin de Glazy.
No, it's Vincent de Glazy.
And this
Maple
is,
Crunch!
This is Croquet a Libertarian.
Maple Crunch for you!
Now this is... Oh!
Be nice.
Now look, this will be nice. For me. Look. Chocolate s'mores.
Dark chocolate. And look, vanilla pancakes! Crepes! Oh, he said I wanted crepes so I can make... No, for me!
Oh.
What about crepes? It's pancake making crepes!
Oh, gosh, Mark.
Crepes!
It's a treasure trove. Look, more truffles.
Oh, my gosh, that's my surprise, the crepes.
Truffles.
I told him I love crepes. There's a restaurant down the street that has crepes.
Crepes Suzette.
That's where I want to go.
I think we need to see what truffles are.
Oh, my goodness.
Mark, this is delightful.
Oh, this one says your name on it, Todd.
Oh, look, a ball. Oh.
This one says Linda. That's the message. Read the message before you go any farther. And this is Pam and Todd. Enjoy. Oh, my goodness. It's a special package. Look how it's beautiful it is.
Dear Todd, this time more gift. Rum coffee and maple taffy for you and your staff to enjoy.
Oh.
The maple chocolates, special pancake mixes, chocolate and vanilla flavors, and cakes. Go to your
don't point.
Lovely wife. And he does say lovely.
Look, nuts!
Frank.
Macadamia nuts! Look, macadamia nuts!
They were for me.
Maple! Well, you can share. You can share.
Pam to enjoy, and she can share with you only if you believe or behave.
Yes, so he never behaves, so he doesn't get any of it.
I believe. All maple syrup products go to you and Robert Goulet.
Goulet.
And your friends at Daddy Pop's.
Isn't that nice?
That's Bob and Cynthia, Daddy Pop.
Oh!
You will notice 11 bottles of maple syrup hockey players that I am being told is the best ever made. These go to your great technicians and support staff who make you look good every time you ship a machine to your customers. And she does list them. Linda, Frank, Wallace, Steve, Kurt, Jason, Tony, Walt, Jonathan, and Scott. Just to name a few.
Look at all this.
Look at this treasure trove.
Not one, but four coffees.
Well, that's 2.5 pounds,
young lady. Look at this, so cool. My own glove.
Now here are the hockey players.
My own container.
So each of the lads will get Canadian. We'll have to bring them in, Pam.
Jelly, this is
look,
jelly.
This is specifically addressed to me.
This is Todd and
you.
What's this? There's two of them.
I had to do
Linda
that.
Linda already had this one.
I had to put that ticking in.
This is Linda. That's ours.
Oh!
Open it up!
We opened up Linda's by mistake?
No.
Okay. It's the same thing. So that's for Linda. And that. Because we'll leave the seals on it.
And we have how many guys? One little, two
ten.
Little, three little
please
guys.
Don't sing.
Four little, five little,
oh
six
God.
Little guys.
Oh.
Seven, eight little, nine little, ten little guys. They're little. They're not fat like you.
Listen.
You're so mean.
Isn't that the.
Look, you got maple cake. That's what you need for more of this.
Well, yeah, but
what's
you got chocolate
stuff?
Cake.
Here, another cake. A chocolate cake. Oh my gosh, look at this. Double chocolate with strawberries.
Well,
I gotta go buy the strawberry. Oh, and it's got a raspberry on top too. Oh my gosh.
That's probably be enough for dessert for you, you know, for this for lunch. And then you could have one of these.
You know what? Good thing it's not open. I could just give it to a pie in the face. Next time we need a pie, Mark, so I can pie in the face. That's
this
so
is very
fresh.
Nice, Mark. I'll tell you what, I'm going to bring the boys in and let them select. I'll have my beautiful wife
maple
take
liquor.
Some of her stuff home.
Liqueur.
Liqueur.
Oh, look, here's a picture of it. Look at this.
Liqueur.
Look how beautiful it looks. Oh, look at the raspberries with it.
This is very, very unexpected, Mark. Thank you
these
very much.
These are expensive.
And obviously, we will share
14 ounces.
Daddy poops. We will take our syrup.
That's how our house looked during the blizzard. Right like that. We couldn't use the horse.
That's probably your husband.
Couldn't use the horse.
Martin and Suzanne, like this you're us. Very good to us. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. I hope you like your birthday present. I can't tell what it is yet until you get it.
And now, Pam.
You'll be rocking and rolling.
It's time to get out. So I can show the other boys what they got. Sweetheart, I can make you disappear real easy. Watch. Can you pop out?
No. I'm not leaving. You're fresh.
She's not popping out. Wait a minute. Let me try it again.
You know what? Let's pop him out. One, two, three. Bye! See? Now he needs to go back to work. See you later, Mark. Thanks for everything. You guys are awesome. You gotta come and visit you. I really want to come and see you.
I can't believe she did this to me again. Gives me a chance to do some of my effects. But this is no effect. Look at this. This is that second NBA fast break that we are finally delivering. It's all done. Looks just as nice as the last one, doesn't it, Jason?
It's better.
We have a new ball. We can still buy them. It came from Australia. They also sell the diverter, which you can't get anymore. So they have both parts in stock. It's really good that we can still get them. Isn't it, Jonathan?
Sure.
Yes, and there's the link. So if you need parts for your MBA, that's the place to go. Jonathan, where is the card that's supposed to be there?
You never put it in.
You're the finisher to finish this up.
I'm the rapper.
You see, I'm 6 foot one and I'm tons of fun and I guess coming. Another Hard Bodies. And Back to the Future, we're filming today, aren't we? We have to, the guy's having a stroke. And of course we have this one. But come to think of it, we have some footage we shot yesterday. Let's go back to that. And now I'm having some screech coffee in my Expedition Everest mug. Going back to Disney World this August with the family. We're gonna have fun. Look, I think I showed you before, we got picked Best of Philly for 2015. I know it was last year, but for grown-up entertainment, for our wonderful parties at TNT, and we run our games out. Best of Philly. And we got this nice handy dandy plastic sign to prove it, didn't we, Jonathan?
No plaque?
No plaque. Listen, I gotta also mention that Sam Cullis from England said, my videos inspired him, or our videos inspired him to LED his F-14 Tomcat. Very nice. Well, Sam, look what's coming very soon. Look at the size of this thing. We're actually going to...
size.
You know, I can do this off camera. See? Wait a minute. See? I can do it. Anyway, you're going to see this soon. We're going to have them side by side with a real Spy Hunter and a Spy Hunter 2. A Spy Hunter lover ordered both. Or both. I should say both. Both. Anyway, come on over here because...
Come.
I love doing that.
You keep using the same jokes.
And listen. Area 51, but guess what? It's not. This we made into a combo. Area 51 Max Force. We started off with an Area 51 conversion game. Steven, because you're back after 2 days...
I'll say whatever the hell I want, thank you.
But Steven, we're filming, honey.
Nobody gives a...
I'll say whatever I
want. Clunk. Okay, look. Double side art. Area 51 Max Force. High gloss black paint. I don't know if you watched the earlier videos. You saw how we bring this down. Get the surface nice and smooth. Actually, Tony did. Tony, how long did you spend on this?
Swing
around,
weeks.
Show the boy.
Like a day?
Mm.
5 weeks. Steven's back.
I only get 2 days to work on my games.
The
rest of the games.
Clunk.
All right. New T-Mobile. But let me finish. Customer wanted both games, Area 51 and Max Force, and we can accommodate. I'm going to show you how. First, I'm going to have a sip of this. Now, I love that coffee, Mark.
Okay. Back to you.
Inside is our single Max Force double board. Atari made two different versions of Area 51 boards. This is a single board, and they have a double board. So it's a different kit to do either one. We have our new EEPROMs, and we have a flash ROM to get rid of that stupid hard drive that used to be here. Look, Jonathan, no longer do we have to worry about the hard disk drive.
Yes!
And look, brand new power supply. Now look, do you see the test switch I've done? When you flip that switch, you have on-screen adjustments, which are terrific. You use with the guns. So the customer can change the volume level in the attract mode, which it's in the game mode. All right, our Geo, our 7,000 25-inch monitor. This is the very, very best monitor Wells Gardner ever made, the 7,000 series. New flyback, new capacitors. That's going to last, Jonathan. How many years?
20, 30, 40, 50.
You know, Jonathan.
Hopefully, till tomorrow.
Just because you're working the camera doesn't mean I can't do this. Or this. And that. Did you hear that? Let me do it again. Okay. See? That's what happens when you let me loose on a film editor. Anyway, look. We have the game set at lower volume. When you start the game, it comes up. Now, I want you to pay attention to this. Originally, the game was converted and it only used one speaker here. The clodhopper that converted it never bothered to hook up a second speaker to have stereo. The game defaults to all the sound coming out of the left channel, okay, on the JAMA connection. But if you're smart, you'll hook up two. Because bring your camera in so people can hear this incredible sound. So you get distinct sound out of both sides of the telescreen. Okay? And it's really nice. You get really great stereo separation. Especially when you kill. Anybody else, Jonathan? Dead.
Kill them all.
Who else am I gonna kill, Johnny?
We're shooting a little close. You gotta stand back to play that.
Okay, I'm sorry, John.
You were cheating.
I didn't remember playing this game. Very nice. Very nice. I think it is, John. What do you think?
The cat's meow.
On off switch. So, the customer has both games at their fingertips. No loading time, instant on. So, when you turn the game on, you don't have to wait for the drive to start up or the record to start spinning and the needle coming up. It comes right up. Okay? No wait time.
Fancy.
Fancy, fancy. Jonathan, we move on to our final game of the video, an Asteroids cocktail, or as Tony likes to say, a cocktail. He's not gonna like that. Ooh. Look, what we've done to this, they made 7,986, was it? I wrote down the number. No, 7,939 of these. A huge amount of cocktails, okay? This is the game.
You know about a huge cocktail.
You like okay, this is a 13-inch Wells Gardner. Now, in all the Asteroids, the full-size Asteroids, they Electrohome also dabbled in vector monitors, 19-inch vectors, but Electrohome never made a 13-inch that I know of in a black and white. So Wells Gardner made every single 13-inch vector monitor that we know of. How many games use a black and white vector monitor? 13-inch.
Asteroids. Asteroids Deluxe. Oh, let me turn this off so we don't get the background sound. Asteroids Deluxe. Omega Race, Bally Midway's game. And Battlezone. Four games only use this television. So they are becoming scarcer and scarcer because obviously you can't get the tubes or anything anymore. You'd have to find one of those games. But the cabarets also use the 13-inch. Now, they made 13-inch Asteroids, Asteroids Deluxe, Omega Race, and Battlezone in the cabaret version. Cocktail Table, Asteroids, and Asteroids Deluxe. I've never seen an Omega Race cocktail. Oh, maybe we did have one. So there were a few of them. There's no production runs on them. There are no Battle Zone cocktails. Mm. No, you're supposed to go, wah, wah, wah. Now, they made 47,000 uprights, but only 8,700 cocktails. There's no count on how many cabarets, but look, we left this open so you could see. This swings up, okay, like that. Easy access to the board. We've rebuilt the board. We've put brand new sockets in these four ROM chips, okay? That makes the chips more stable, especially because we're shipping this and it's going to be bouncing over rough roads to get there. We have two new adjustment pots for the telescreen. Now, the nice thing about this, you flip the switch, look at the screen, John. See how this has the square here? I can turn these knobs here. Show the knobs, John. These adjust your size. So you want to have it adjusted so you can see the horizontal. You can still see all four lines on your screen. Then you know you have it exactly right. Now, Bob Roberts, God bless Bob Roberts. Right, Johnny?
Sure.
God bless that man because he sells a complete rebuild kit for your Atari. You get new amplifiers. If you get the whole kit, you also get new capacitors. And then our big blue on the bottom. And of course the monitor's rebuilt. Zanin Electronics also sells monitor cap kits. Now Zanin sells cap kits for monitors you've never even heard of. So if you're looking for monitors, that's the place to go. Zanin, okay? Now, let's get back to this. What we did, control panel over this. Look at this. Here, you see this? This is the original metal control panel. Powder coated by Atari. And the original paint, after all these years, Jonathan, the paint has survived perfectly. Look at that. Now, Stephen had to do a little bit of touch-up, but both sides are in beautiful shape. Now, we did change the buttons, obviously, so we have brand new buttons on it.
And the chrome T-molding.
Oh, yes, we did. This is all chrome here, and the customer ordered a new plexiglass top. Figure it out sooner or later. All right, come over here, Jonathan. Now, cleverly, our start player buttons are built right into the computer. And this will program it. Now, do you see the double flash? It means it's the newer board. Okay. Actually, I think if you have a cocktail, you have to use the newer board because I think they had a problem with the screen flipping. See how great a player I am, Jonathan? Look at how gorgeous that picture is. The 13-inch pictures were, of course, even sharper than the 19-inch ones. And the 19-inch ones are as sharp as your highest definition TV made today. Unbelievably beautiful, gorgeous, sharp picture. See how I avoided that, Jonathan? Aren't I great?
Big great pills.
I know. Did you see how I cleverly worked in that great pills thing? And of course, when you're done,
you crash.
Our screen flips back. Listen, Jonathan, while I finish this game, let me take you to Daddy Pop's that I filmed earlier today in the morning, showing off, of course, Mark's wonderful new stuff. And then I'll be right back.
Ah, another trip to Daddy Pop's. Who's in there today?
I don't read French very well.
What do you have there? A gift from Mark. It is
super
Deriria
syrup the arable.
It is 100% pure, Cindy.
Arable.
Your very own tub of maple syrup.
Very good. Thank you too much.
And we also have
maple spray. Wow.
Maple spray.
You have to send directions for this, Mr. LeBlanc. We're not exactly sure what you use it on, like your toast or pancakes or.
You gotta say egg.
Egg?
Egg. Chili egg.
You don't use it?
It's maple syrup.
Maple syrup.
Thomas, you can't leave yet.
I've got to leave.
I'm trying to hold on.
Boys, don't want to be late one more time. You don't get any Friday lunch.
That's right.
Works out.
You know, now he's the man we like. He's mostly worried about where he eats his breakfast and his lunch.
You can look at that part. That's part two.
But, not like the guy holding the camera that is out to lunch.
Well, I think it's time we look and see what's available in the used car division. Oh, gosh. George Kennedy has passed away. You know, the last surviving Munchkin died, too.
I think he was 96 years old. That Munchkin's off to see the real wizard.
She just take the bag for the dog prints.
And look, she gave it, that's her bag.
Right here?
It came from a dog store.
Dump truck is here, but nothing fun. But nobody seems to want that 93 dump truck. Are you still here?
I told you.
The first part of our breakfast.
You had to get in your office before you did.
Oh, he was visiting my office on the other side.
No man can eat 50 hard-boiled eggs. That's from Cool Hand Luke.
Yeah, but
I think Paul Newman did.
He did, but he was the egg peeler. George Kennedy said that nobody.
That was a good movie.
Nobody could eat.
But I liked him. I liked him in Airport, and also in the Naked Gun series.
Pure maple spread, and Stephanie is filming.
Oh, look at that.
Whoa! And
I changed the diaper.
The lad here.
That's
Bob says I can use some of this delicious maple.
That's serious slathering you got going on there.
That looks like something I already double slathered.
And of course the April and black currant. The remains.
Is it apricot or is it berry?
No, apple. So that's
apple.
Why
is it red?
That's a major league slathering.
Currants are red, right?
What do you think?
Yeah, I guess they are.
Looks interesting. All from England.
Oh, that's nice.
When is Mr. LeBlanc coming south?
Yes, when are you coming?
When are you coming south?
Well, first of all, he just got another foot of snow.
That's his customer who sends him all the goodies, all the maple.
What do you think? Can we try it?
Yum.
We'd love to buy him breakfast.
Just like Mom used to make. That's why I left home.
Is it newsworthy?
It's good.
Yeah, look, it's even good on his shirt.
Oh, did I?
Oh, is it? I don't think so.
Here,
your turn to film. Film him nice now. Give him a wide angle.
Tell Mr. LeBlanc we're real big red.
That's kind of where the action is.
Oh my God.
I kept it healthy. I got the orange juice and the grapefruit.
You ought to put a little of that stuff in your orange juice to see if that livens it up.
What a breakfast.
Well, the twins have gotten an almost identical meal, but he has added cheese and
patties.
Are they turkey patties?
No, they
didn't get turkey patties.
Oh man! And they've dressed identically.
Get your royalty payment before you go on the air
to capitalize on the twin. And Debbie is refilling the mug. We finished reading the paper.
Pennies. Sorry.
We're gathering pennies for the machine, and you don't have any either. Do you have any pennies for the machine?
Chris, my man.
Are pennies that scarce?
Well, we have a few more pennies, thanks to this kind man. It's a mother load of pennies.
Yummy.
Yeah, Mary will appreciate those pennies for her
retirement fund.
You don't think she's going to take these pennies away, do you? Russell, we have some pennies to put on the machine.
All right. Take some more, please.
Now I got plenty for the kids to play. And I think it's time to get back to work. Another day at Daddy Pop's. Ah, we're back on this side. It's the end of my game, Jonathan. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. We were going to run another one after this, but I'm afraid it's already hitting up to our maximum time. We don't want to make these videos too long, so you get bored. Anyway, good night, and we'll see you again later this week.
Good night. Now, bus!